Our previous years at TT, it's always with a smile. Even though there's been some odd times, real odd times, and been really lucky to be able to come back and compete and have another go at it.
It's your life, it's your destiny, really, to compete at TT and try and do well. Being physically ready for TT, it's hard to replicate TT. Barreling through a forest on your mountain bike, dodging trees and, you know, racing each other, that's quite good to be up to speed with that kind of thing.
That side of it is down to you, and it's just how much you want to do it. Getting out of bed early or staying up late to fit it in wherever. The intensity of working on the TT bike is massive. They're not a mass-produced thing, and we make them ourselves. Every little bit of work that you do, you're thinking about it going round that track. What you expect from a helmet is you need something that, firstly, you're confident in, that you know that it's the best thing that you could put on your head and give you the best chance should something go wrong. The way that it gives you vision under varying conditions. You can go from being 20 degrees to 10 degrees in a matter of minutes.
The aerodynamics of it and the shape of it have got me spot on. You know, you don't want any buffeting or, you know, any excess movements.
There's no other choice in helmet for me, for sure.